You gonna stay here for the video, Winnie? Yeah? Hey guys, what's up? It's Cort, and I realize I have not filmed a video in like 4 weeks, which is insane in like YouTube time, but I've just been going through a lot and having a lot going on. But I promise I'm in a very good place right now, so there's nothing to worry about. I just haven't really gotten a chance to film with work and school and personal things and whatnot. So anyways, today I thought I would go ahead and do an easy video. I'm going to be doing the song tag, which I've seen a couple of my favorite YouTubers do, and this is kind of like an older video, but I felt like doing it now because, you know, just late to the trends, and that's how we're going to go about it. But anyways, without further ado, let's jump right on into it. Alright, so the first question is, what is a song that perfectly describes your life? I had a very, very hard time choosing this, and to be honest, like, I'm not totally secure on what I chose, but like, it's very hard to pick one singular song that describes your entire life. It's very hard. But I ended up choosing Lighthouse by The Word Alive. I feel like this song is just very positive, and even if you've gotten beaten down, you're gonna keep going, and that's kind of how I've gone through my life, as you know, like, I may be crumpled and like this like damaged little person, but like life is still going on and I'm still gonna push through and become an amazing person in the end. So Lighthouse by The Word Alive is a very good song, and I think it pretty much describes my life and how I revolve around things. So yeah. Describe a song that reminds you of your childhood. It'd have to be Dare You to Move by Switchfoot. This song came out in 2008, I believe. I was probably around like 10 or 11 during this time, but I was so obsessed with the song. I thought it was so powerful and so amazing, and I loved the song. I probably played it every day of my childhood. Like, I thought the song was great and amazing. And so yeah, whenever I think of my childhood, I kind of think of like Switchfoot songs. That was kind of what I grew up with, kind of what my brother listened to at that time, and so that's kind of what I listened to. So yeah. Name a song that reminds you of your dad. A song that reminds me of my dad would definitely have to be You've Got a Friend by James Taylor. This is just like when I was younger and I couldn't sleep at night, he would come in my room, and before he would say goodnight, he would sing this song. Anyways, a song that reminds me of my dad would definitely be James Taylor's You've Got a Friend. It's just something that he's always used to saying to me, something that you can tell is like our song. Next is name a song that reminds you of your mom. A song that reminds me of my mom would definitely be any song by Bon Jovi, but mostly the song Welcome to Wherever You Are, which is such an amazing song. If you guys have never heard it, like, go listen to it. Like, even if you don't like Bon Jovi, the message in that song is just really, really grand. But yeah, my mom's always been obsessed with Bon Jovi, and she's kind of raised me with Bon Jovi. But yeah, I mean, Bon Jovi has always been my mom's thing, and that song is kind of a song that she's always loved. And I remember during my senior brunch, when like you sit around with all the other seniors and you're like opening letters for people and teachers and friends and whatnot, my mom had actually written me a letter, and inside was the lyrics to that song, and next to each like verse she had written out like advice or what the lyrics meant to her and how she wanted me to take them. And it was just kind of really cool how she like interpreted everything to me. So that song is really important to us, and I really like that song, and if any song reminds me of my mom, it would definitely be Welcome to Wherever You Are by Bon Jovi. Name a song that is often stuck in your head. A song that's often stuck in my head is Stuck in Your Head by I Prevail, which, ironic, right? It's such a catchy song. It's always stuck in my head. It's not one of my favorite songs, but I don't particularly hate it, but it does get stuck in my head a lot. I promise if you listen to it like one time, it's gonna be stuck in your head for like the rest of your day, so yeah. Name a song that reminds you of your best friend. A song that reminds me of Maddie would definitely be I'm Not Okay, My Chem. Honestly, any song by My Chemical Romance is gonna remind me of Maddie, because she's like their number one fan over here. It's like her favorite band ever, and I feel like My Chemical Romance and Maddie, like, it's just a thing right there. But I don't know. I mean, I remember we went to the beach one time, and she got a tattoo that said I'm not okay, and then I got a tattoo that said Darling, You'll Be Okay. And if you guys know the references, it's a Pierce the Veil reference and a My Chemical Romance reference, and it just went together perfectly. And so whenever I think of her, I always think of her song I'm Not Okay by Chemical Romance. name a song that makes you hopeful. A song that makes me hopeful would definitely be Crossroads by I Prevail. I've been really obsessed with that song lately because it has such a great message to it, and it's so catchy, and it's so realistic. It's not like over positive or like overly like excited, like it's realistic and it's really good and powerful. So Crossroads by I Prevail, if you're ever down, I definitely recommend going to listen to that song. I really enjoy it and I think it's really good and really hopeful. Your favorite song by your favorite band. My favorite song by my favorite band, which is definitely not Pierce the Veil, like, is gotta be Divine Zero. And I first listened to the song when it first came out, and the day it came out, I was actually on a plane to the Bahamas with my family, and I was so obsessed with it. I probably played it the entire time that we flew to the Bahamas, like on repeat, like that was the only song. I think that song and Mad at Myself by Issues, I literally had a playlist with those two songs and they just went on repeat the entire time. But Divine Zero is a song that I still have yet to get tired of and I replay it all the time, and it's actually the song that I want my first tattoo to be. I know people say don't get lyrics tattooed, but honestly, I love the lyric, "A million waves in the ocean crash at once to make you smile." I think it perfectly reflects who I am because I love the ocean and surfing, I love positivity, and I love Pierce the Veil. So yeah, it just combined is amazing. I love that song, so yeah. Name a song you love singing along to. A song that I love singing along to would probably be Never Lose Your Flames by Issues. If you play this song in the car, it's guaranteed that at one point in the song I'm gonna be singing along. I just love the range of the song and how it goes fast and how it goes slow, the message behind it. I love singing that song. I don't know why, but then again, I love singing any song that's in my music library, so. Name a song that has made you cry. Definitely been the acoustic version of Disappear by Issues. It made me cry even before I knew the meaning behind it, but then once I watched the video about it, why Tyler wrote it and whatnot, I cried my eyes out even more. And I'm really not an emotional person. Like, unless it's like something really intense to me, I'm probably not gonna cry. Like, I would break my leg and not cry. Like, I don't know. But that song really got to me, and it really has such importance to Tyler, and I'm blown away by the actual meaning behind it, and it's so sad, and I just gets emotional sometimes. So that song is definitely a song that has made me cry. Name a song that you could chill to. Honestly, I could probably chill to like any acoustic version of a song. I actually have a playlist on Spotify that's all of like my favorite bands and their acoustic songs. So that's a really cool playlist that I like to listen to. Anything on there is probably something that I would chill to. So I'll link that down below if you guys want to check it out, because I don't know one specific song that I would chill to, but anything on that list is something that I would lay in bed and just relax to. Name a song that you love but rarely listen to. So there's two songs that I really, really love that I rarely listen to. They're both by Pierce the Veil. Shocker. The first one is Kissing in Cars, which I love that song, and I love the way that it was made. Like, it was actually a song for one of Jaime's best friends that was gonna be a gift for a wedding, but then it like got leaked or something like that, and it's such a personal song, but it's so beautiful. So Kissing in Cars, which is an acoustic song, and then also Hold On Till May by Pierce the Veil, which is such an iconic song, and I know it's probably overplayed and oversaid, but I really do love that song. But I really don't play those two songs that often because of fear of getting sick of them or getting old to me. But I really do love those songs. It's the first song alphabetically in your library, and that is going to be Hangover by Alestorm, which I promise you guys, like, I don't listen to Alestorm at all. But honestly, I think my brother was listening to it one time, and then like I like did the app where you can like figure out what the song is and you can look it up, and then I downloaded it and I didn't mean to download it, and then it, just this whole thing. So that's the first song. I don't even think I ever played it besides like that night. So yeah. The last song alphabetically in your music library, and that is Lie to Me by 12 Stones. A good song. Love that song. Don't play it a lot, but it's a good song. Your favorite party song. My favorite party song would probably be The Downfall of Us All by A Day to Remember. I feel like everyone and their mother knows that song, and that's one of those songs that everyone's gonna be singing along to and everyone's gonna be screaming along to, and it's just super enjoyable and super like high energy and just something really, really fun. So The Downfall of Us All by A Day to Remember. is name a song that you would never get tired of listening to. A song that I never get tired of listening to would probably be like Faint by Linkin Park or In the End or anything by Linkin Park, because I feel like over the years of my existence, which is not that many, but over the 18 years that I've been alive, I've listened to Linkin Park at least once a year, and I feel like I still have not gotten sick of them, and this band has just stayed with me throughout my entire life, and I have not gotten sick by any of their songs, and I haven't, you know, like thought like, wow, like this song is really overplayed. I feel like all of their songs, or majority of their songs, are really, really well written, and they're really like kind of all over the place, so they're really enjoyable and you never really get sick of them. But I think like if there was one particular song that I would never get sick of, it would probably be Faint by Linkin Park. So yeah, anyways, that is the song tag. Again, I apologize for being absent for so long, guys. I promise I'm good. There was just a lot of stuff that I was trying to figure out, and I live a very busy life. But yeah, anyways, I hope you guys have a great day. If there's any videos that you guys are interested in me filming, make sure to comment them down below. I do know that I'm going to a concert in a couple weeks, so I will definitely have like a concert vlog or concert video or something of that nature up here for you guys to see. It's gonna be a really good concert. It's some people that I have not seen before, and I'm going with my friend Maddie and my friend Medallis, and this is gonna be Medallis's first like actual concert, and it's gonna be really intense because the bands are pretty intense. So yeah, it's gonna be really interesting, but stay tuned for that. Anyways, I hope you guys have a great day, and I will talk to you guys in my next video.